What we know is that the authorities in Mexico are desperately asking for more help. They're having troubles getting ambulances and rescue workers to the area. This happened in the western end of Mexico City. As you know, it's a big city, and they're having problems trying to get people to come and help. We see in the evacuations by air, by ambulances, whatever method they can do. Rescuers have been working since very early in this morning. This happened around 7 a.m. with a gas tank was delivering gas to the kitchen section of this hospital, which is a maternity hospital. Authorities say that the hose delivering the gas ripped off, something sparked a fire, and the building exploded. We do not know yet if all the damage we're seeing is solely because of the explosion created by the tanker, or if there were other issues, like we know a hospital might have oxygen or other gases used on the daily operations of a hospital. At least 30 to 40% of the building has collapsed. This is making the rescue efforts difficult. People on the ground say that there are babies still under the rubble. They're trying to get to them, and they're trying to evacuate them to other hospitals. As you said earlier, at least 7 people have been confirmed dead, and the authorities are trying to find out how many more might be trapped. Fred?
Yeah, Gustavo, and those are absolutely horrifying pictures that we see there from the scene, and it certainly looks as though there might be other victims in this explosion. Tell me, those people who have been brought to hospital, what do we know about the types of injuries that they have? Is it mostly from debris that was flying around? Is it mostly things that might have fallen on top of these people? What sort of injuries do they have?
This is the information we have so far, and that's correct. Initially, the first people who were able to be evacuated were people who sustained injuries because of the flying glass, the debris that hit them. Some of the pictures on social media show bloody faces getting into ambulances. The more severe ones, as we have seen through these images from our affiliate, are being air evacuated. But the extent of the injuries, we do not know. Obviously, some of them were severely injured, because now the reported dead are some of those people who at least were able to be pulled out of the rubble earlier.